So I'm doing a very, I think a very intriguing challenge, and it's a very interesting build concept as well. Because it A, shows off the power that crits have, and also it shows off how bad it can screw up some of your other stuff you're going on. And so the build is, you've got all the crit relics plus 3 extraordinaries on top of 1 all orb nothing. The whole thing is like, oh yeah, you have all these great relics and you're using orbs that cannot benefit from the relics whatsoever. Because they actually have zero ability. There's 0/2s. With all of these crit relics, there's 0/2s. Crits are not supposed to be better on the extra ordinary. I refuse to believe that. So it's actually I've had quite a few failed runs, and I've found that it's actually surprisingly difficult. Who'd have thought having 3 useless shots a turn? 3 useless shots in every reload? Kinda hurts. But I am restricting my use on the discards, because I'm like, well, that kinda defeats the purpose of having as many as I do. Because if I have discards available to me, what's stopping me from just getting rid of my bad orbs, right? So I absolutely am just skipping, I am neglecting discard. Pretend it doesn't even exist. And that's basically it. It's a surprising challenge, and it's honestly really quite fun. Because you always need to be hitting a crit most of the time, but you also need to weigh the benefits of just going for a bomb versus the going for, oh man, oh, I thought it was going to not hit a single crit there, which would have sucked, but somehow it hit 3 bombs, which is pretty awesome. Sadly, I do think I will pick up another extraordinary if it is offered to me, because I never like losing the setup that I had, which kind of sucks. Especially because it was on the first, pretty much, encounter. And it does make my deck a lot better by having one less, but it's also, like, not in the spirit of the challenge. And a very fun one, indeed. A very fun one it is, indeed. Very difficult, though. I will say, second floor, I can't get over how every single... There's, like, no scenario I've run into yet where the third floor is easier than the second floor. The second floor just seems like it, because of the shields, it's just so, so overtuned. And there's a lot of just the chip damage fights. You'll end up taking just so much damage. I don't have any healing in this build, and I don't have access to any healing either. Because, again, I like to keep it relatively simple and relatively what's the word? I've already forgot the word that I was thinking of. I have a pea brain, I guess. Overwhelmer. I have added the Overwhelmer just to... Oh, man. I really do not like this. I have added the Overwhelmer just so that I can deal with the shields and the second floor a bit more, because it was pretty impossible without it. Like, I did a few runs of not having Overwhelmer, and it was pretty much impossible. Like, I was taking 60 damage frequently on the first fight, and it, at that point it's like, okay, is it really worth it? No, it's really not. And I really want to get more extraordinaries. I want to keep, but I've somehow managed to get rid of all of them. So I wonder if I target there, if it's going to do exactly what I want. if it's gonna like hit. Ah, it didn't hit all of them. I was hoping it would do like hit the front one and then also hit the three flying ones, but it only hit the flying ones. Kind of sucky. But alas, that is okay with me. Should have definitely targeted that a bit better. It's only gonna hit the front one now. Kind of unfortunate. Don't know why I did that, but it's okay. I do have an open bomb here? Hopefully? Yeah, there we go. I just need one more shot now, and I'm not too worried about taking one extra damage here. If any crits would show up in my vision, that would be nice. Okay, that's the best I'm gonna get. Very nice. Good enough. I was just basically waiting for a crit to show up anywhere near where I could actually touch it. But sadly, until that point, no shot. Okay, let's see. Just another fight. Sounds good to me. I'm just gonna basically shoot until, like, most of the things are out on the field, because, like, with Overwhelmer, I think it's gonna be able to just tear through everything. I really wish I had another extra Orbinary right now. I really wish I had another one. On the bright side, the mole boss, I wonder if the tree is gonna survive very long here. I really wish I had my all or nothing as my first orb there. Ah, shame. What can you do, though? Still okay. It missed it! No! It would have done so much. It still did. Pretty sizable. It did like 200 through the tree, so I'm not complaining too much, but I think it would have ended it right there if I had actually managed to hit that third crit. But there we go. We're all done. Very nice. Skipping all that relics. Who needs non-crit relics anyway? One relic I was debating adding, I decided not to, was Betsy's Hedge. The one that gives one additional normal damage to your shot. For every crit on the board, and my reasoning for not adding it was, like, I really wanted the extra Orbinary to be, like, a 0-2, like, pretty well useless to really do, like, okay, this is, like, a high roller, and, like, I'm getting the orb or not at all. It truly is an all-or-nothing deck. I said the line. Haha, funny, right? But yeah, it's truly an all or nothing deck, and so my thoughts were like, why not? Why not just make it more insane? More fun. The more insane, the more fun, right? That's how that works. Very nice, getting through everything quickly. And it's kind of like, even this fight, it would be a pain without the Overwhelmer, because, like, at minimum, I'm shooting it once, and then shooting... Oh, damn it. So I'm upgrading this. I really don't want to, though. At minimum, I'm shooting it once to kill the shield, shooting it a second time to kill the front one, shooting it another time. And it's just like, well, at that point, I'm just going to be taking so much chip damage that I'm just going to be dead by the time I get to it. Because I have no way to heal. Sadly, this is just a 2-2 now. I mean, most of the time I'm critting anyway, but it does make non-crits viable now, which kind of sucks, because I wish that wasn't the case. I'm going to try and refrain from upgrading it more. Very good. Very, very good. Maybe I could have looked into mods. Maybe mods had the solution for me to really encapsulate this challenge. Ah, dang. Survives by 10? and I take extra damage because of it. Very sad. But everything ends now, and I can just heal up a bit now. So we're all good. I bet if I upgraded the extra ordinary to level 3, it would just become insane on a non-crit. I'm kind of curious to see how much it would be. So I think next time I'm offered an upgrade, I'm just gonna check, you know? Cause like my curiosity might get the best of me, right? Ooh, huge. Huge. Alright, let's see. Good crit placement. Not the best shot to go along with it, but it'll do. It will do. All or nothing. Down the hatch. Thank you. Just heal and head down here. What point am I? Oh, I'm at this point. Okay. Damn it, not this fight again! Oh, this fight is the worst normal fight in the game. Absolutely the worst. It has everything I hate about, everything I hate in one level. It has shields, it has blinking stuff, it has projectiles, and it has not that many bombs. Everything about this entire stage sucks. Just shoot there. Decent shot. Not great. Honestly, this is what I mean by, like, projectiles just sucking. Like, I am just gonna skip. I hate this stage enough that I'm breaking my own rules. I'm sorry. I'm not losing to this fight for a third time. And yes, I have lost to that specific fight 3 times already. I am not doing it again. I hate that fight with a passion. Hopefully I get, like, a duplicate orb, question mark here. That would be ideal. Oh, I can actually see here. It goes to a 12, oh my. And I think that's not even accounting for some of the other crit synergy I have there. Just leave there again. Sounds good to me. Just gotta make it to this demon wall. Just gonna go for as many bombs as I can on the extra ordinary shots, and then I think I'm actually gonna go for crits on the all or nothing, because in my many attempts I have noticed that you kind of do a lot of damage to these things with that, so it's generally a little bit better than bombs. Not by a ton, but a little bit anyway. Please hit a crit. Thank you. I think that's actually the entire fight. There we go. Very nice. Into the demon wall. I think this is actually going to be a pretty easy fight. Although, watch me bite my tongue on that one. The first shot is going to be pretty useless, because it's just going to end up being beaten up by the front two enemies anyway. But the real scenario comes from when I get the extra ordinary. Hopefully it leaves the board pretty full. It does. Where am I going? It looks like this might be the best spot. Hopefully it makes it right here. That's the exact point I wanted it. Very nice. Huge damage. 4,000. I think, honestly, this fight's probably easier than the other one as well. Like, I think it also really helps that I have only one extra ordinary right now. Again, if I get offered another one, I will absolutely take it. Because I would like to keep the spirit of the challenge alive. And I feel like at this point I am getting a little bit sidetracked with it. That's okay. That is a-okay. Okay. You're not gonna hit a crit, are you? No. You're gonna hit two bombs. but not a crit. Okay. And there we go. I mean, again, didn't even kill it on a crit, which sucks, but what can you do? What can you do? Ooh, get the Minesweeper boss. Maybe I have a decent setup for the Minesweeper boss. Because I know it does... It's pretty good to have, like, just high single-shot damage. And that is kind of exactly what this build excels at half the time. exactly half the time right now. So it's either going to go really well or really poorly. We'll see. I'm not anticipating it to go either one way or the other right now. Although, that being said, it generally goes pretty bad. Generally goes really quite bad. I'm just gonna skip. I'm probably gonna get forced into that elite fight, aren't I? Yeah, I didn't really want to take it. Hopefully it's a Slenderlin. I think the Slenderlin's the one that's most easily dealt with. Not this one. This one is definitely not going to be... Although it could be pretty easily dealt with. Depends on the how many crits I hit, really. Oh, man. What? Okay. I've got to hit a refresh here. There we go. Not even that good of a shot. Okay, never mind. It was a pretty good shot. I take it back. Pretty much ended the entire thing, which was really needed because my first few shots were absolutely garbage. No! How did you do that? No! It's not true. Oh, that's so sad. Okay, so it's really close to me now. I do need to end it really fast. Thank you. Guaranteed damage. I think this is gonna be enough to kill. Yeah, definitely. I think it was enough before that, but it's now just absolutely just done. Wild amount of damage. Going to skip everything there and just head down. Oh, went into the fire. Okay, works for me. Probably going to avoid the next fight as well. It kind of scares me a lot, in case you didn't realize. Kind of scares me a lot. Ignore it and keep going. Absolutely. This is where I want to go. I think I want that side. No matter what, I have two chances to go that way, so I'm pretty safe. I think, anyway. Here we go. Okay. Hopefully I can finish off both of these fights easily enough so that I can actually heal before the final boss. It's currently my healing situation is not too great, if I do say so myself. Okay. Should be a pretty good shot here. Not great. The whole map here isn't great. But hopefully it's not the worst thing in the world. Okay. Crit here, thank you. I think the front one dies. If it hits a second crit, both die. It does not. Okay. This could go really poorly now. Absolutely, this could go really, really poorly. Or, I guess it's gonna go decently. Could have gone a lot better, though. Absolutely. Let's see. Please give me a reasonable fight to deal with. This is... No! It avoided them all! Oh, that could have been so good! Sadly, it missed. I think every possible chance it had to have a crit, it, like, missed. And there was a lot. There's absolutely a ton of chances for it. So I'm probably gonna lose health overall in this fight. When probably should have been a pretty easy. Yikes. Okay. This hits, like, a lot of the normal bombs, really. Or even if... Oh, there's no guaranteed crit here. Okay, good, good. And it was just a normal bomb. Nice. Very, very nice. Come on, come on. Bombs, do me a solid. Do me a solid. You didn't do me a solid at all. A little... You had to get a little bit more chip damage on me, didn't you? Duplicate a random orb? And if it's extra orb... I'm gonna duplicate all orbs. I'm getting close to the end, and I think it can go either way, really. Enter the Tear, I think is for the best. The Mole Boss is definitely the worst of the two. But I definitely do just want to get as much healing to give myself the best chance of possible to deal with the final boss here. I think it's going... Yes, very nice. I got a good heal off here. Very nice. And now 74 health going to the final boss could be better. I have no way of healing, so... We'll see how this goes. I have no idea where any of these crits are. Oh man. Oh, I managed to hit one. That's gonna count for something, right? Maybe another? Oh, another! Huge! Starting off with 4,000? Gladly take 4,000. And if it even hits another one, another big shot here too. Maybe? Pretty good. Pretty good start. And now, I did get really high rolly there, so it could go really poorly now. We'll see. We shall see how this goes. Hopefully it doesn't hit that red bomb. Very good. Absolutely did not want it, because I'm pretty sure how this bomb works. This boss works is the more crits you hit, or the more red bombs you hit, the more dangerous it is. So I really want to avoid as many red bombs as possible. And Come on. I think we're good. I think I got it. Oh! First time killing that thing was in a challenge run that I thought was actually quite difficult. But anyway, if you like the video, please consider subscribing. I've got tons of different Peglin content, Backpack Hero content, and just general other roguelites on the channel. So check me out.